So I'm going to show you how I multiply the African violet. It's very easy to reproduce. It's very similar to the succulent. I have three here. And the only issue that I've had is not their growth. As you can see, their leaves are pretty green. And I water them about once a week. They're pretty nice. And you can usually with African violet, you can tell if it's dying on you or if it's too dry because the leaves will start feeling soggy. But these ones are pretty nice. So that hasn't been an issue. My issue is they don't flower. If anybody has tips on how to make the African violet flower, please let me know. There are four different classes of flowers here. I know one is purple, one is pink, I think one is white. And my mom gave one away. And I get my African violets from the 99-cent store, and they do grow. This was my favorite leaf. As you can see, they're different. Like here, you can see the stem is purple. Here, the stem is white. This is probably the white flower one. So you can see in this one's a little bit roughly, this one's not. So you can see the difference in all of them. But my mom gave one away without asking, but I'm okay with it. So I'll show you how I multiply it. Multiplying the African violet or reproducing it, it's really easy. They said all you really need to do is get a cutting. I've gotten cuttings with long stems, and these are short stems. I just got a tip that if the longer the stem, the harder it's going to be for it to grow new leaves. So I shortened the stem this time. This is about a week. They've been here about a week. I've noticed that they usually grow roots. They usually root about 2 weeks. You'll have a root. And I just had some a while back, and I had them for a couple of months. For a couple of months. And then I started noticing that they started giving out new leaves, and that's when I decided to transplant them. Actually, my mom transplanted them for me. So I'll show you how those are looking. I'm going to show you this one really quickly. You see how long the stem is, and it's been here for months, and I haven't seen any new foliage from it. So, that tip about having shorter cuttings is probably true. So that one's just sitting there, doing nothing. Then I have another here, and that one's dying off. So sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. Okay, so these are the ones that I had in water for a while, and you can see the baby right there, right there. You can zoom in. See the baby right there? And the original leaf died off, so I'm gonna pull that one off. And this one, this leaf is still there, but it hasn't given any. So I have a couple of them like that. So that's how I multiply my African violet. I'll probably update you and tell you how this one's doing. And have a good day.